Hello everyone, this is Brad here. Today I'll be showing you how to install Minecraft so that it works on an HTC Vive VR headset. It has a list of steps and multiple downloads, of which you'll find every download linked in the description below. So let's get started. Of course, you gotta make sure that you have your Minecraft downloaded and installed. Once you ensure that Minecraft is installed, we gotta install the Java JDK 1.6, 1.7, or 1.8. The GARE, which is the Java Runtime Environment, will not work for this. It has to be the development kit. For today, I'm gonna be using the JDK 1.6, 0, 38, and 64-bit. Again, I'll have the link in the description below. So once you get to the page of the Java SE development kit, we're gonna be using this one. You're gonna click Accept License Agreement, and then choose your runtime. Please note you may have to create an account or sign in with the Java website. Once you have it completely downloaded, be sure to run the installer. And for the most success, I recommend just choosing the default directory. Click Finish. Now that you've successfully installed the Java Development Kit to your system, go ahead and click Windows key or open up the menu to search for your list of programs. Type in Environment, and you should see Edit the System Environment Variables if you're on Windows 8 or greater. Click it, then down here you can see Environment Variables. Click that. Then in this window, under System Variables, go ahead and click New. And variable name, you'll type in Java underscore home in all caps. And for the value, you want to browse the directory of which you installed your Java development kit. So for me, I installed in my program files. So I want to go to this PC, C, Program Files, Java, and here it is, JDK 1.6.0 underscore 38. So just click that and click OK. Then click OK again. In the same window, in the same system variable section, you want to scroll down a little bit until you find Path. Click Edit, and click Edit Text. And we'll go to the very end and copy and paste what I have in the description below. Then you click OK, and OK again. Now that you installed the Java Development Kit and set your environment variables, now we gotta download the Python kit. For this, you have to get a version of 2.7. I'm gonna choose 2.7.11 for this, so download. So once you download the correct Python kit for your system, go ahead and run the installer. But pay attention to what I do here. On this page in the installer, scroll down to where it says add python.exe to path and activate entire feature will be installed on local hard drive. This is very important. Then click next. Yes. And let it install. And hit finish. Now we want to return to the GitHub page linked in the description and click the download zip and let it download. Once you successfully download the zip folder, go ahead and extract it with whatever program you use to extract files. Alright, and go to the directory of which you extracted it to. So in the directory that you just extracted, you want to double-click the install.py file. And then you'll see in the command prompt that comes up, that it's going to start downloading the zip file. Let that finish. After that's done, your CMD window will automatically disappear. And then you want to go up to build.py. Go ahead and double click that. Once the build.python file has completed its business, you can scroll down, and you'll notice here, blah 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 blah, Vive installer.exe. Double click that. Click yes, and then here, you want to browse to where your Minecraft folder is. And then you'll click install. Once that's done, it'll say installed successfully. So restart Minecraft and select the Minecraft Vive 1.7.10 profile. Alright, now that you open Minecraft, you can go down to your Minecraft Vive 1.7.10 profile and click play. And bam! Now you can completely enjoy all the VR experiences that Minecraft has to offer. And let me tell you, there are a ton of them. Again, thanks for watching. If you found this video useful, go ahead and click the thumbs up. If you had any issues, put a comment below. Maybe me or someone else will be able to help you in the process. And have a great day!